Okay, you guys. Well, this is a big moment right now. And although we have a very big switch to signify our very big moment, that thing's not, is that live?
It's live.
Okay. Somebody, I need like rubber gloves to get on that thing. Okay, good. Well, first of all, I want to say thanks to everybody for being here. It's another in a series of amazing days for an amazing town called Poolesville. And we're here today to celebrate the fact that we've cooperated with a whole group of different people, come up with a great idea, put it down on paper, negotiated it, and boy, it was some of the people here know how tough a negotiation that was. But how long did that last? A couple years, right? Couple years of worth of negotiation. But now here we are, and we stand out at what was formerly a unused section of our wastewater treatment plant, a beautiful wastewater treatment plant, I must add. But we stand in front of an area that was completely unused and an area that was ripe for some sort of development that makes sense. So 2 years in the running, a lot of negotiations. I want to give credit to our former president, Eddie Coleman. He came up with the idea. And with that idea, we had a chance to put together something that's special. And I said, to me, in just a series of special things that that make Poolesville stand out, not just in Montgomery County, but in this region and our part of the country, as far as I'm concerned. So we've got a great story to tell here in Poolesville. And I know that this is just it's a hot day. I won't go on forever, but it's a beautiful day. I'm going to be one of probably 9 politicians that comes up here and says that I ordered the sunshine and that it came in as per the queue. But the fact is that here we stand, you're here, those are generating electricity, they are working silently and all the time to create energy that helps support our town in a very green way and also to reduce our town taxes. I don't see how that can be anything but a great thing for not just the town, but for the region. I'm very proud of my fellow commissioners that are behind me, starting over here with Jerry Klobuchowski, Chuck Stump, Valerie Dickerson, Bryce Halber couldn't be here. These are the people that sat and just grinded out the process to come to this conclusion. I want to thank Wade Yost, our town manager, who never let me, I never threw in the towel because I knew Wade wasn't going to throw in the towel. Our town manager, John Strong from Huron Consulting, all these people worked very hard, along with our partners, UGI and Standard Solar. You'll hear a little bit more from them in just a minute. So without further ado, we will have some dignitaries that are here and have blessed us with their presence, and we're really lucky to have them. They're showing their support. I know I said blessed, Brian. We're blessed to have their appearance here. They're going to say a couple words too. I don't want to keep them too late because I know that Mr. Leggett overheats, and I don't want that to happen here today. So without further ado, I want to bring up our county executive, Ike Leggett, for a few words. Let's hear it for Ike.
Thank you very much, and congratulations to Poolesville. One of the operative words you heard a moment ago is that we had to grind it out, forecasting a very difficult, costly, and consuming process. I had a chance to discuss with Eddie a little bit earlier about many of the earlier challenges. One of the things that we should make certain that as we continue to evolve in this process, to ensure that solar is available, that it's done in a much more simplified fashion, that we do not have to go through grinding it out in difficult circumstances and conditions, to do something that is so commonsensical. That is to take advantage of the open space that we have on occasion, the availability of solar, and the needs that we have within the community. I am delighted to see that Poolesville has grinded it out, because it can set now a model of what we can do for other communities around this county so that we will not have to go through such a difficult process to do something that you have done. So I want to congratulate you for what you've done. This is, in fact, a very, very unique process and something that has been accomplished in a very, very strong and a definitive way. But I think that there are other opportunities throughout Maryland, and certainly here in Montgomery County, that we can follow that can ensure success for the future. Congratulations to you. This is a defining moment for our community, but one which we will not say in the future that is so unusual, but it becomes an acceptable thing. It will be so because of what Poolesville has done already. Congratulations to you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Leggett. That was well said and much appreciated. Next up, for a little more insight from the state level, I'd like to introduce our Senator Brian Feldman.
Well, when you're around politicians, as long as many of us have, everybody takes credit for everything. So when Eddie Coleman told me earlier that, in fact, it was his idea, I was like, sure, Eddie, I'm sure this was all your idea. So I'm glad to see that was, in fact, validated. So congratulations to you, Eddie. You know, from the state of Maryland, first let me acknowledge my colleagues from District 15 who are here today. Kathleen Dumay could not be here today, but we've got Delegate Aruna Miller right here. Wave, Aruna. And we've got Delegate David Fraser Hidalgo right here. And I actually serve on the committee in the General Assembly, first in the House and now in the Senate, on the Finance Committee that actually deals with energy policy. And in fact, we've done some great things as a state going forward in terms of renewable energy and promoting it. And I think we're a leader in the United States. What I love is the fact that in terms of within Maryland, that Montgomery County has always been out front, particularly in terms of renewable energy. I think there's two other municipalities in the entire state that are doing this, but this is the first of its kind here in Montgomery County. So I love the fact, and I know Aruna and David love the fact, that here in District 15, it's the first municipality in the county to have a setup like this. Eddie did tell me that the reason it couldn't be more than it is we have some prohibitions at the state level that unless you're a utility, you couldn't actually power the entire town this way. And therefore, one of the things that maybe when we get back to Annapolis in January, since I'm on the right committee, maybe there's some things that we can do using this as a first step to you know, this could be, again, a pilot or a model for the entire state of Maryland. And we may need to pass some bills to remove some prohibitions, et cetera. So on behalf of the state of Maryland, Governor O'Malley, and the whole team from District 15, I want to congratulate you, the town of Poolesville. Thank you, Jim.
Thank you, Brian. That's very generous of you. And you know, anytime you state guys want to come down here and see how it's done, we're happy to meet with you. Bring our team with us here. Thanks for the kind words, Brian. Of course, very generous and apropos, and as said, it's a big step forward for the town. Next up, I would like to ask our county council member, Roger Berliner, to come up and say a few words. Roger.
Let me just add my congratulations to the town and to Standard Solar. When people talk about grinding it out, it does take it on both sides to make a deal like this work. But your perseverance in making sure it does work for you is what's most important. And what I love about being here in Poolesville in this moment is that Poolesville has such a unique character, such a wonderful history. And it is so important to keep that unique character, that history, and at the same time to achieve this kind of progressive end result is so incredibly nice. That combination of honoring who you are at the core of yourself and embracing the future in this way is what defines forward-looking communities, the best kind of communities. And so you exemplify that. And I'm just proud to be here, proud that our county, I see Councilmember Leventhal here, another strong solar supporter, that our county is now going to be buying 100% renewable energy for our county. and that you are going to be doing this contribution for your community, it really is very important, because this is a clear win-win, a win for the taxpayers and a win for the environment. That's what we all want to achieve. Thank you very much.
All right, I'm getting used to all these compliments. This is good news. Hey, you guys, we're going to do something big. Once every, fill in the blank. 3 years. Okay, once every year at least. We got to have higher goals than that. All right, good stuff, you guys. Thank you for that very much. Appreciate, once again, Roger, for you making it up here. And you've always done well by us, as has our senator and our council members, rest of our council members, et cetera. And, of course, Ike Leggett, thank you. So next up on the list, you know, we've kind of run our course with politicians, although I'm still up here. Next up is a guy that I have to say that he was the most genial negotiator that we've ever run across. He kept saying yes, but then he had other people that said no. And I love that kind of negotiating. So it felt like that we were not really negotiating. It was a friendship until the hard guys came in. So that being said, really, there wasn't really any tough guys in the whole thing. Everybody just kind of worked together. Although there was that one moment in that one boardroom where we stepped away, and then you guys stepped away, and we came back in, and you... Yeah, okay, got it. Okay, got it. So without further ado, I want to bring forward our partner here at Poolesville Solar Array, Tony Clifford of Standard Solar. Tony.
Poolesville town officials, residents, honored guests, it truly is a splendid day to be outside in early June, dedicating one of the largest municipal solar systems in the state. And today feels like an early summer day. I think that, you know, spring was the weather we had the last couple of days, and then we had winter. And I think the people in Poolesville, they remember the winter. And how many Standard Solar people are here today? I mean, we got quite a few. And I see Bruce waving his hand back there. Bruce spent a lot of time out here in the middle of winter trying to get this thing finished. And, you know, between the snow, the rain, the mud, it was a challenge, but we got the thing done. We got it done on time, and you know, we're going forward. Now, when we look at the, you know, solar is really changing a lot in the United States, and this solar revolution is being led at the state and local level. And with that in mind, I'm really not surprised that Poolesville, which is one of the leading small towns in the state of Maryland and in the Mid-Atlantic, I'm really not surprised that they decided to take a leadership role in solar. So today we're standing basically surrounded by a substantial solar array that we completed, and it's been running for a couple of months now. And this system is an economic, environmental, and educational opportunity for the town of Poolesville. It's an economic opportunity, as the cost of solar electricity being generated by this system is less than the town is currently paying for conventional utility power. And in the first 12 months of operation, this is going to save the town about $30,000 in electricity costs. From an environmental standpoint, the solar system allows the town to make a real contribution to the fight against global warming. And, you know, with the announcement about the EPA new regs on coal that was announced by the president today, I included a coal analogy. This system will offset about 2.4 million pounds of carbon dioxide annually. And that's the equivalent to the amount of CO2 that's produced when you burn 1.2 million pounds of coal. So we're really making a substantial contribution to reducing the amount of CO2 in the atmosphere when you put up systems like this. Now, this system also is going to help educate the leaders of tomorrow about solar energy. The project has an educational component that included learning tools that are tied into Poolesville High School's Environmental Science Magnet Program, and that gives the faculty the opportunity to incorporate solar into their curricula. And I know that our head of engineering, CJ Colavito, there's CJ over there, CJ's already been out to the high school talking with students in one of these classes, and I know he's going to be back. So finally, I just want to say that we have a win-win-win situation here. And with the completion of this project, the town of Poolesville wins economically, environmentally, and educationally. So in closing, I'd like to thank the town of Poolesville and its elected officials and employees for selecting Standard Solar and our financial partner, UGI, as the firms to design, develop, finance, install, and maintain this system. Thank you very much.
Very nice, and said it's been a pleasure the entire time, Tony. Thank you.
Most of the time.
there's always a little bump in the road every now and then, right. So that's fine. That's to be expected. That's why we have Wade. That's not funny, is it? Okay, good. Anyway, Tony, did you want to introduce your guys?
Oh, I'm sorry.
That's all right. No worries.
I wanted to introduce a couple people. We got Lee Bristol here. Lee's kids all went to Poolesville High School. He lives down the road a bit. And Lee was the original guy in charge of getting this project off the ground. And he had a lot of support, but he did that. And then we have Mike Hartley. Mike is our director of structured finance. Mike was at a lot of those town meetings, and he occasionally said no, but nicely. And then we got CJ, and I mentioned CJ. And then we've got a bunch of other people. I'm not going to go through everybody, but you know, this was really a team effort by Standard Solar.
Thank you, Tony. And I agree, a team effort, and you guys have done a fantastic job. Thanks for being on site, everybody that's worked for Standard Solar on this. Okay, so you've gotten two-thirds of the picture here. You have a town that was willing to do something pretty cool, and then you had a company that was willing to be paid to do something pretty cool, and then you had to have somebody that would finance that. So you know, as you know, the town taxpayers didn't finance this. The town's taxpayers just get the benefit from it. Not just from a green fashion, but from a money fashion. So speaking of the money, we have our financier, and once again, you were in the same boardroom. I think you were the hardest one to negotiate with.
It was my money.
Well, there you go. All right, well, that makes a lot of sense, and it was great putting it together. This is Chuck Miller of UGI, the financier, and come on up, Chuck, and tell your story.
Thank you. It's a great honor to be here today. You know, this is a magnificent system. It's an example and a model system that, you know, we're going to be displaying for many of the municipalities, you know, around Maryland and Pennsylvania as well. I think one thing that Jim left out about ordering up the sunshine today is that we were contractually obligated to provide it. So, so we have fulfilled our obligation. You know, we talked about the process of getting to this point. You know, the sausage making, and nobody really wants to see all the grinding and how the sausage is made, but everybody likes it when it's done. And really, that's where we're at today. But there's a lot of hard work and a lot of effort that goes into getting something to this process. UGI and UGI Performance Solutions, we're a gas utility in the state of Pennsylvania, the largest gas utility in the state of Pennsylvania. And we're more than just a nameless, faceless bank. You know, we understand that we're going to be here for the next 20 years. We're going to be Poolesville's partner for the next 20 years. UGI does not traditionally build a project and flip it and sell it off to somebody else. So when we show up in the boardroom, we show up because we know we're going to be answering to you for the next 20 years. And you know, we've already talked about the different benefits that come along with this. Tony has mentioned, you know, the increase in electric prices, the environmental benefit that's going to be, you know, gained from the installation of this system. But you know, there's economic benefits that are going to be translated to all of us. These opportunities create jobs, maintain jobs, you know, keep people employed, doing good for the environment. You know, green is good, so to speak. So you know, we are proud to be the partner for Poolesville for the next 20 years. We're proud to be working with this exceptional team and this exceptional town. I also, on behalf of Standard Solar, would like to point out those guys back there leaning against the fence hiding, because I made them stand out here in the freezing cold, in mud up to their elbows, trying to get this project done by a deadline, because in order for us to give you all the pricing and the great electric rate that you have, they had to finish this at a specific point in time so that the finance company, UGI, could realize the tax benefits associated with that. We gave them an impossible task, and they rose to the challenge, and I want them to know how much I appreciate it. It was a great job. So with that, I'm hoping that I'll be invited back to the next soiree 3 years from now, or 1 year from now, depending on how he sets those goals, for what your next opportunity would be. And as I said, UGI is excited and proud to be the partner of Poolesville for the next 20 years. Thank you.
All right. And we couldn't have picked a better partner, so thank you very much for bringing everything to the table that you have, especially the cash. We appreciate it. All right, so next up, and this actually leads into an easy segue. To be able to put something together like this, oh, sure, there was people back here that just, you know, worked, and we met, and we talked, and we emailed, and we had a lot of conversations. We said no, we said yes. We finally came to a meeting of the minds that's led to what we all have here. But we couldn't have done it without the solid support of a group within Poolesville that has helped us provide the leadership to create the solar array. So, as you can imagine, and especially the politicians in the crowd, not everybody's in favor of everything. So, we realized that, but we had a job to do, and we needed backup, we needed support, we needed somebody to have our back. And that was, we're very fortunate to have a group in Poolesville that is takes environmental stewardship very seriously. And with that, I bring up Joyce Breiner of Poolesville Green, a great organization that supports the town. Come on up, Joyce. Sorry for the podium.
Not in my wildest dreams. In January 2008, when I encouraged the commissioners to adopt green initiatives in the town's policies and practices, did I envision I would have electric cars in my garage and solar panels on my roof to power them in my home? And most certainly not in my wildest dreams did I envision standing here today, just six years later, to celebrate today's ribbon cutting for the Poolesville Solar Array. I am in awe. I commend and heartily thank the commissioners for thinking big, thinking bold, and thinking outside the box. Special thanks goes to former Commissioner President Eddie Coleman for not only being open to ideas, but taking a lead in investigating this new way of municipal stewardship. And thanks to Commissioner President Jim Brown for picking up the ball and moving it to a conclusion regardless of the outcome. Thanks also goes to those in the community who saw the possibilities and spoke in favor of the project, educating all of us along the way. And thanks to those who expressed reservations, for it is that which causes us to dig deeper for better understanding and clarity. Fellow residents, I have no doubt that our children and our children's children will long applaud this effort of our town's leaders and be awed then, as I am today, with their foresight. I can't wait to see what's next.
I should have been caught by surprise on that one. That was good, Joyce. Thank you. And I'll work with you on that. I like the sound of that. You know, Joyce hit it there. Not only is our solar array part of our green initiative, but we're the only town hall in Maryland that has a pervious surface parking lot. We're also one of the first users of LED technology inside our streetlights. I know that the board that's behind me, at least, fully supports green initiatives in the future, so the more that come up, the more we're going to listen, and the more we want to be a part of it. Makes sense from a lot of reasons. This one just happened to be smart from a financial sense, too, so that was very good news. Most of the time, they are. Okay, so here we are. We've kind of got everything lined up. I'd like to say that we've turned them off so we can turn them back on, but I'm ready to throw the symbolic switch for it. If we could, I wouldn't mind having Mr. Leggett to come on up here and be a part of our switch throwing, since without his county leadership, I'm not sure we'd all be doing this right now either. So without further ado, we get ready to light the, turn things on. And if you hear a humming noise, just stay still. It's okay.
Jim, do you want the rest? Jim, all do you right. want the rest with you?
Oh, yeah. Any other elected official want to come on up, you guys?
Runner.
Eddie. Come on, man. Eddie.
Not until Randy says this is stage.
That's good. That's it. Maroon, if you say that. David, you're going to have to move a little bit. There you go. Okay. Just going to make sure
does
you're
look
all
okay?
In. Ah, yeah.
The six commissioners.
Yeah,
it's still a 50-50 gamble.
There we go.
Okay, you ready? Okay, you guys, thanks to everybody here. We officially declare the Poolesville Solar Array open and operational. Yes. Thank you, my friend. I really appreciate that. Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Okay, you guys, so two other items real quick. Number one, everybody that's here is welcome to tour the solar array. You could just walk right through there. And you can see where it's roped off a little bit. Be careful because it's still a little pitted up back there from the construction, but you can go up and look at a solar panel up close and personal. And then you know that we're having a catered dinner for everybody that's here up at Town Hall. Come up and see our beautiful Town Hall and be a part of the fun up there. Mix with the people here that brought all this together. We love talking to you all, you know that. Thanks to everybody for all their efforts and for being here tonight, and we'll see you at Town Hall. Oh yeah, we're Dave. You guys, one more photo op. We're supposed to cut the red tape here. Come on, Chuck, get over here. You're supposed to be a part of this.
Okay. All right. I will never get that picture set up here.
Jim.
Just make sure everybody gets there.
Aruna. Aruna.
Ryan, where's Roger?
I'll take one.
Here.
Golden
scissors. There you go. Everybody in here first. Hold on.
That's not a scissor.
Don't cut quite yet. Hang on one second. Let's get everybody tight and in.
Joyce,
Wade, can you come? Wade, you want to come over to the
Joyce,
side?
Joyce, you want to squeeze in front of Aruna? You're a little shorter. Make sure Brian.
Chuck, make sure
is everybody ready out there?
Okay. All right.
One,
we got everybody.
Wait a second.
That's amazing.
Are you ready?
All right. Go ahead.
One, two, three.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody, thanks again. We'll see you at the solar array. We'll see you up at Town Hall. Appreciate your help. Appreciate everybody's help today. Thank you.
I'm Hopefully this will be.
Are you doing anything else?
Yes, it is. Oh, no.